Hello, this is Kurt Worley, FX strategist and trader coach at FXBootcamp.com. Today is Wednesday, February 6, 2013. As I speak, it's about 12 minutes after 9 a.m. New York time. We're in the first couple hours of the New York morning trading session on the day known to many as Hump Day. You're looking at a four-hour chart for the Euro-USD currency pair on the Awanda MT4 trading platform. This chart may look familiar to some of you who've been watching my trader alert videos. I showed this the same chart yesterday, and yesterday I discussed the prospect of the Euro-USD being trapped in a trading range defined by the 3470 to 1.35 zone of support. You see the line at 3470 here. At 3470 zone, put a lid on the euro in late January here, and you can also see yesterday's lows very close to the 1.3470 zone. Anyway, that area being support resistance, I mentioned in yesterday's trade alert video around 1.3585 to 1.36 zone. You can see that the 1.3585 area represented by the horizontal bright red line in this chart. Put a lid on the euro back in the late January there. Put a floor under the euro in the wake of last Friday's NFP report. And sure enough, during today's Asian and early London session trading, the euro USD found resistance in that 3585 to 136 zone. So here we are, basically in the middle of this trading zone here. It began between about 1.3470 to 1.35 for support, and 135.85 to 136 for resistance, and we're some 15, almost 20 pips off the 135 level. We did discuss in today's New York morning trading session at fxbootcamp.com a prospective long around 136, and I'll talk about the prospective target for that. But the point I wanted to make was this: the kind of scenario of price action we discussed yesterday looks likely to play out, barring any unforeseen news or comments out of Europe, which could spark a renewed strength in the Europe's single currency. So the market, as I expect, given the lack of any major news today, and especially given the ECB rate decision and press conference tomorrow, market likely waiting to see what ECB President Mario Draghi has to say during tomorrow's press conference. So we're probably in a stall mode here. Yes, is there a trade to be had? Possibly. Let's talk about that on a 15-minute chart. Here's the 15-minute chart for the euro. Euro again just off of 135, now almost 135.20. This could be a potential flip point here for the euro. The 135.20 zone put a floor into the euro here earlier. Let me move this label here for a second and freeze the chart so I can activate my drawing tool. Yeah, euro could potentially flip here and turn south. But I see the possibility of the euro continuing to rise here, maybe forming a higher low, potentially breaking above this downtrend resistance line defined by the highs established earlier today, and returning at least to the daily central pivot point. To today's daily central pivot point around 35.45, you can see some recent highs there. Also, the 135.45 zone affected price action on yesterday's New York morning session, as you can see on the left-hand side of this chart. So I'm anticipating, again, barring any unusual circumstances, unusual news headlines out of Europe in particular, that the euro is going to simply continue this game of sort of ping pong in this between the 134.70 to 135 zone for support and the 135.85 to 136 area for resistance, playing ping pong in that zone until the ECB meeting. So in terms of a profit target, if you get a second chance long around 35.10 or so, you could target 35.45, again, the location of today's central pivot point. Or at most, maybe you target 35.70. You can see some price action respecting the 35.70 level earlier today.